Welcome to Showreel. I'm Jacob Paint.
And I'm the new host, Claire Abbotts, replacing Mark, who unfortunately can't be with us anymore as he's fallen down a well.
That's not true. Anyway, later in the show, we'll take a look at the newly released British film Alan Partridge, Alpha Papa.
But first, we'd like to introduce today's guest host, award-winning actor Adam Fawns.
Hey guys, thanks for having me on.
So Adam, are you allowed to tell us about the film you're currently working on?
Sure can. The film is called Killer Smile. It's the adaptation of a novella by the author Anita Bell. And this feature-length film we started a few months ago, and it's seen us in the Snowy Mountains, it's seen us up at the Sunshine Coast, and I also got to fall off a horse. So.
Wow, that's pretty cool. So how much longer is it? Have you still got to shoot?
We've got one whole day, but of course there's pickups and ADR and everything to deal with. So it's been a long journey, but it's been really, really interesting. So.
And so is that fun. You've come back from Canada just to shoot Killer Smile?
Or? Yeah, so I'm living over in Canada indefinitely to try over the acting scene over there and come back to do this one. And of course, a 48-hour film that we did together, so it was worth the trip.
Yes, and I still have to give you your prize for Best Actor Award that I accepted.
Absolutely.
Good luck getting that. Good luck getting
that. I know, right? I'm not sure that all of it's there, but, Jake, it's all about the award, really.
Yeah, that's right. I'm glad you think that way.
Exactly.
So how was it? Did you find the 48-hour experience? Because I know you've done that a couple of times before.
Yeah, a couple of times before, especially with Jacob before, and it's the usual fare. You know, you get there on a Friday night, usually meeting new people, and you all learn a lot about each other because you've got to write a script together, get something done by Saturday morning, and then film this thing without any sleep. And it's as fun as it is frustrating, and it's amazing to see just something come out on Sunday.
Yeah, and sometimes that's better than others.
Yeah.
That's true. Sometimes you get people who make absolute gems come out on Sunday. You don't know how they got the location or the idea, but in the end, you know, it's good fun. But always afterwards, you want to go make another short film and think, I'm going to do this so efficiently. We're going to make something amazing. But then you don't. You do another 3-month job and you get more sleep though, so it's good.
And you did the 48-hour film, did you do it in Canada as well?
Yeah, we did. It was a Toronto-specific competition, so it wasn't part of the 48-hour film global competition, but still we did it again over there. It's the same kind of thing. Doesn't matter if you're in another country, it's still little sleep, crazy ideas, and when you get something in the end, you look at it and go, what were we thinking? You know, your parents are proud.
Yeah, I'm sure
hope
they
so.
Are.
Hope so. So
they haven't seen all of your films, clearly.
No, absolutely not. I hide them from the bad ones. That's all of them, I think.
So, when we did ours, obviously you were in there right from the start. You actually helped us write, which I don't think many actors, unless they were like the writer writing it and directing it or acting or something like that in it. Not a lot of the actors come in and actually help with that. Do you find it more helpful to be there right from the start? Because
I love it, I guess. You know, from the start, you don't know what actors you'll need and what characters they're going to play. So it's good to have that input. But I think from our session, correct me if I'm wrong, I kind of offered all the bad ideas so you guys know what to steer away from. And I think I helped that way.
Wow. So some of your improvising obviously made it into the end of the film as well. So
it did, yeah. I like to play. But it was great fun. And you guys kind of just, we got a structure together. We knew it was a really strong idea. So we went with that. And then you give the actor a little bit to play with in the end and it makes it fun.
So how is Canada, and what are the challenges you're facing over there?
Right, first thing, snow. So we have 2 foot of snow all Christmas, which is, it's beautiful when you wake up to it the first day, but then every other day after that it's just annoying, you know. But my girlfriend and I went over there to try the acting scene. It's really exciting because you have major feature films going there for tax benefits or for location, whatever it is. But it's just amazing to have RoboCop shooting in Toronto. We have Godzilla shooting in Vancouver. We have mutual friends working on that at the moment. And it's just very inspiring to have this happening there. On our part, it's making sure you have the right visas, making sure you understand how the union works. It's a little bit of a different thing from Australia, but all challenges you want to surpass and have a go.
Okay. So we'll see if they let you back into the country.
Fingers crossed. Absolutely.
Why did you even get into acting in the first place? What really drew you to that?
I guess because I love being the class clown, you know, and all my friends are much funnier than me. They're great at it, and so I kind of took that as inspiration and wanted to do that. I actually studied in IT, so I'm a computer nerd by trade, and I thought it doesn't have as many girls and parties as what they told me it would. So, you know, I...
You're doing the wrong course. All I've heard is all girls and parties.
I did the wrong course. Thanks, Griffith. But apparently it's a new Griffith now, so maybe that's what they do.
Yep.
But yeah, it's something I've always wanted to try, and I thought I'd just do it part-time. But yeah, it's just getting things to do like our 48-hour film is great.
Like, you're really good at improvising, though. When we're actually doing the 48-hour thing, you sort of... Like, you were doing a lot of accents, even when we were not filming, you're just staying around just doing like a 40s gangster or something. And like, you actually got a really good gift for picking up those accents or just an ear for that sort of thing. So, like you were mentioning in Canada, I think we were talking before, and there's like comedy clubs and things you can go to. Have you ever thought of trying out like improv comedy or improv acting like that?
Absolutely. With improv, when it, you know, part of some of the games is getting up and being a different character every time. You know, some of it is, you know, being yourself and just going with the scene, but coming up with new characters every time is one of the tenets, and it's just so much fun. It's interesting, recently on the feature film I tried to help out, I was AD and help with crew a couple of the days, and I actually watched the other actors do the accent thing and playing around. I realized how frustrating it can be, so sorry to all the crew out there. it's fun for us to play, but I think it's one of the things that just keeps us have our energy and keep awake, you know, and do that kind of thing.
Yeah, I'm wondering about, I mean, you're always, Adam will do impersonations of other local actors and whatnot.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm just wondering if he does impersonations of me when I'm not around as well.
No.
All right, so if anyone has any footage of that, if you can...
it's actually part of the segment later. We'll cut that together if we can.
Right, okay.
See what we can do.
Look forward to it.
Yeah.
So how many films have you and Jacob actually worked on together? Because I've seen Lime, which is one of your 48-hour films. Have you guys, like, have you guys known each other from when time you started acting, or how did that...
Pretty much, I'd been doing it for a little bit, and I think he'd been doing it a little bit longer, and so we kind of converged on this film. And
thought, oh, really? He's done it longer than you?
Well, actually, my first film that I acted in was... Adam was the lead actor. That was... And we had Ray Sinclair that was on the other week.
Oh, yes.
So that was Enclosed in 2006. That was when I met Adam.
Nice.
Good old Ray. Hi, Ray.
It's been love ever since. Aww.
Yeah. But it's one of those things where I jumped on the short film with Jacob, and I saw this amazing talent here, amazing ideas that we both had as we were sharing while we were shooting it. And I thought one of the things in Brisbane is to make your own... Make your own projects, you know, write your own stuff and make it happen. A lot of my friends I know working with agents kind of sit there and wait for the calls to come in. That is part of it, and it does pay the rent, but also got to make your own work.
Yeah, you really need to be proactive sort of in film, because it's not going to come to you, is it?
No, not all the time, unless you're a lot better looking than me. So, you know, then it comes to you. But, you know, working for your own stuff means you can write your own characters and make it perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, no, we've had some fun. We've got our YouTube channel as well, where you can catch some more of them. our ridiculous hijinks.
Absolutely. Well, one of the things Jacob and I do, we try to write something for ourselves, and every now and then we get a little bit lazy, and it takes a little time. So we just get up, take the camera somewhere, and try and improv something, which is a lot of fun. So you'll see the results of that on the YouTube channel.
Well, that's all we have time for this segment, but up after the break, we'll be airing our 48-hour film, Day in the Death. See you soon.